My name is Drew and I'm a solutions architect at NVIDIA. Today I'll be showing you how to use the NVIDIA Agent IQ Profiler to get deeper insights into the performance and behavioral characteristics of your agent workflows. For this demo, we're looking at Agent Morpheus, an AI agent example for ZBE analysis. Let's kick off a round of Agent IQ before we explore some of the configurability of the agent itself. The Agent Morpheus system, built by NVIDIA, can quickly triage vulnerabilities in software containers and code. This is incredibly helpful, as analyzing software for vulnerabilities is often a critical but time-consuming step in the development process. The input to the agent is a vulnerability that needs to be triaged. This also includes information about the documentation, as well as where to find the code itself. A large language model then creates a checklist of things it needs to investigate in order to triage the vulnerability. The same checklist is then processed by another agent in parallel. The agent performs retrieval augmented generation on the code in addition to the documentation of the container to understand if a particular vulnerability exists. Once all our checklist items are executed in parallel, there are two other model steps that occur. First, all of the findings are summarized and then created into a vex justification, which is a justification about a vulnerability existing in a container or not. That is then passed to the user. This process end-to-end saves a lot of time with Agent Morpheus. Where it would usually take security analysts and operators hours, if not days to do, Agent Morpheus will finish it in a minute, as we'll see. As we see the agent thinking and observations on the right-hand side, let's explore how the agent is configured in Agent IQ. You have functions, which are the tools and agents themselves that do various things. For example, we have one to search a vector database, another to search the internet, to search the software bills of materials, etc. We'll also have LLMs that are used in the execution. For example, we'll have an LLM for a checklist, for a vector database, for the retriever, execution, and so on. The first step to create and run a profiler on a workflow is to ensure the profiler is part of the evaluation harness that's native to Agent IQ. So, you must add a configuration item at the bottom of the configuration YAML file that tells Agent IQ how to use a profiler. Then, we'll tell Agent IQ where to save the data, as well as where the input data exists that's going to be used by the profiler. Then we'll tell Agent IQ what kind of metrics we'd want to look at. For example, if we have hyperparameters for each of those metrics, we should add them here. Let's try computing estimates for workflow runtime. We can also forecast how many unique tokens are created by the agent and LLM in the execution of the workflow at each step. We can also identify bottlenecks in workflows. And we'll explore all of this as we look at the output of the profiler. We see on the right that the profiler has successfully completed, and now we can explore some of its output. One of the primary outputs of the profiler is traces of the execution of the agent itself. We can look at all of the intermediate steps, thoughts, actions, tool usage for the agent, including where it came from, what its function ancestry was, how long it took, and even what framework it came from. For example, if an agent system was implemented on LangChain as well as Llama Index, we'd still be able to trace all of those in a single view. Now, this may be a little hard to read, so we also standardize the data in a data frame that contains all of the same information, just in a columnar format that may be a little bit easier to interpret. But more importantly, we also have open telemetry integrations that allow us to view this data in a UI such as Phoenix. We can look at each of the agent tool calls and the execution, look at the latency of the LLMs, look at what went into a tool and what the outputs were. We can do this for LLMs, tools, retrievers, etc. All natively and transparently to the user, so whether they're implementing in LangChain, Llama Index, or another framework, we're able to comprehensively observe intermediate steps. Another metric we can look at is inference optimization, which is helpful when collaborating with engineering teams to optimize workflow runtimes. For example, we could identify commonly used prompt prefixes, so that we could pre-populate key value caches for NVIDIA NIM to increase throughput and reduce latency. We can get a better understanding of how workflow runs or how many unique tokens there are between every agent call and an LLM, which may allow us to make smarter decisions about the serving of the LLM itself. We can also look at workflow runtimes and latency confidence intervals. From a developer perspective, we provide additional metadata. This allows us to look at understanding how workflows run in real time. We also provide a profiling report. This allows developers to look at, for example, where the bottlenecks in their workflows are. Is it with the LLM, or is it a certain tool? The last example we'll look at is how a workflow runs at various concurrencies. We can look at LLM latencies at multiple concurrencies, so we can make smarter decisions about how to deploy these workflows. For example, if we're seeing a lower latency at a high concurrency, that's good. But if we wanted to reduce our latency at a high concurrency, maybe we'd make smarter deployment decisions about the cluster on which this runs. But all of this is to allow developers to pinpoint where their bottlenecks are, where they can optimize their workflow so that the next time it runs, it will run faster.